Bam, Mr. True. Okay, we're in part two here. We're going to expand our introduction of finding antiderivatives and the indefinite integration process by showing you how to use an initial condition to find a particular solution. Now, what I mean by that is we have here y is equal to the antiderivative of f of x with respect to d, and that is equal to f of x plus c. We talked about how when we do find an antiderivative from a derivative, if that's all we're given is that derivative, then remembering that the derivative of a constant is zero, when we find that antiderivative, we don't really understand or we don't have enough information to find out what c is. So there's many, many solutions when you find an antiderivative. All those solutions are just simply vertical translations of themselves. So again, the antiderivative of 6x with respect to d, with respect to x is going to be equal to 6 times x squared divided by 2, which is equal to 3x squared plus c. I should have added that plus c here as well. So we have f of x is equal to 3x squared plus c. So I don't know if this parabola, someone got my little dog barking there. I don't know if this parabola, this has a power of 2, so I don't know if this parabola, you know, passes through the origin, or maybe this parabola had a vertical shift of 2, and thus passed through the point of 0, 2, along with many other points, of course. You know, I have a plus c, I have a constant at the end. So while I know the family of antiderivatives, I don't know the solution. Now, if we are given just a little bit of information beyond the derivative that we're finding the antiderivative of, we can actually find the original function. If you're given the value of y equals f of x for one value of x, you can find a particular solution, the one original function for the conditions that are given to you in your problem. What you're going to do is first find the indefinite integral, that general solution, like I have here with my f of x is equal to 3x squared plus c. You're going to use the initial condition to find c. In other words, the problems, and I'm not going to finish this one, but the problem will say, okay, the original function is equal to 10 when x equals 2, something like that. And we're going to plug those values in, find the value of c, and then, you know, with that specific given, you know, that one little point that the graph, the function actually passes through, we'll find c, and then be able to write our particular solution. We're going to do two examples, so this will be a fairly quick video, and let's get to them right now. So we have the problem, find the original function for which f prime of x is equal to 4x plus 1, and f of 1, so this prime symbol is gone now, so we're talking about the original function. F1 is equal to negative 2. So, of course, first we need to find the antiderivative. We need to do the indefinite integration for f prime of x is equal to 4x plus 1. So, we have the indefinite, the integral of 4x plus 1 is equal to 4. We're going to take that exponent of 1 and increase it by 1. So we have 4x squared 4 times x squared divided by 2 plus 1x. And again, of course, plus c because we're finding that general solution. So 4 divided by 2 is equal to 2x squared plus x plus c, and this is f of x, our antiderivative. Well, unlike my previous video, now we're given a little bit of extra information. This function passes through the point of 1, comma, negative 2, or when x is equal to 1, f of 1, or f of x, is equal to negative 2. Plug in a negative 1, or excuse me, plug in a 1, get out a y value of negative 2. So, what does that mean? That means that f of 1, when I take the value of 1 and plug it into this function, the overall value is going to equal negative 2. So, negative 2 is equal to 2 times 1 squared plus 1 plus c. So again, I'm plugging in my value, my x value of 1, when x is equal to 1, so the x's come out and 1 goes in their place, the entire function's value is equal to negative 2, or y equals negative 2. So we have 2 times 1 squared. Well, 1 squared is 1. 2 times 1 is 2. Plus 1 plus c is equal to negative 2. That's negative 2 is equal to 3 plus c. And subtracting both sides by 3, we get negative 5 is equal to c. So, unlike before, where all we could find was a sort of general solution, an antiderivative with an unknown constant here at the end, we have now our particular solution, the original function. And that is, using this value of c, f of x is equal to 2x squared plus x minus 5. And that's pretty much all there is to it. We're going to find that antiderivative. We're going to take the initial condition, plug it in, and find that particular solution. I got one more example. It's going to be a fairly straightforward algebraic example, but they're going to be giving us the second derivative instead of just the first derivative, and that problem will simply need to be worked out in two parts as opposed to just one, because we're going to have to find the antiderivative twice to go from the second derivative that's going to be given to us to the original function. Before we start our last example, I do apologize for getting that little dx notation at the end of my integral expression to say that we were finding the antiderivative with respect to x. Solve the differential equation. F double prime of x is equal to 6x minus 4. Given the initial condition for the first derivative, which is f prime of negative 2 is equal to 19, and then finally f of 0 is equal to 1. Since we're given the second derivative, we're going to have to find the antiderivative twice to get back to the original function. It's the second derivative, so we have to do the antiderivative twice to get back to that again. So, given this, we are going to find the antiderivative of 6x minus 4 with respect to x. That is going to give us, let's see here, it's going to give us 6 times x squared divided by 2 minus 4 times x, we're going to raise, well, just times 4x, plus c. So we can find that general solution. And then 6 divided by 2 is equal to 3x squared minus 4x plus c. Now, we started with the second derivative and found the antiderivative of that second derivative with respect to x, which means that if this was f double prime of x, then this is f prime of x. And again, that general solution. So we're going to use the initial condition for the first derivative, which says that when x is equal to negative 2, the entire function, the entire first derivative, is equal to 19. Plug in an x value of negative 2, get out a y value of 19. So f prime of x is equal to 19 when, again, x is equal to negative 2. So we have 19 equals 3 times negative 2 squared minus 4 times negative 2 plus c. That gives us 19 is equal to 3 times 4, negative 4 times negative 2 is positive 8, plus c. 3 times 4 is 12, plus 8 plus c. That's 19 equals 20 plus c. And now when you subtract both sides by 20, you get negative 1 equals c. I'm showing all these steps, of course, to help you better understand what I'm doing, but also, as we're starting to learn, a lot of calculus problems are very long, so the more steps you skip, the sloppy you are with your notation and your handwriting, that makes it much, much easier to make those small niggly mistakes or careless mistakes that, you know, we get to the end, we basically followed the right processes, but our answer is wrong. So make sure you show those steps nice, clear, and precise, so that when you get done, you haven't wasted all that effort to get the wrong answer because you did, you know, I don't know, 2 and 2 is 5. So now that we found that value of c, we can go ahead and plug that back into our general solution for the first derivative and find that particular solution. So coming up here, we have f prime of x is equal to, or the first derivative of f, is equal to 3x squared minus 4x, now minus 1, because now we know what c is equal to. Okay, we're going to have to go through the antiderivative process again to get the general solution for the original function. So we're going to take the integral of 3x squared minus 4x plus 1 or find the antiderivative with respect to x? Ah, yes, with respect to x. If it's easy for me to forget that, I'm sure it's easy for you. Make sure you are particular with your notation. Your teacher will not be happy if you keep forgetting that. So we're going to have 3 times x. We're going to raise that power by 1. And again, divide that by the same value. Minus 4, raise that exponent by 1 and divide by the same value, just using that power rule with each of the individual terms, minus x plus c. Now, this is the first derivative. We just did the antiderivative, which now means this is our, or going to be, our general solution for the original function. So f of x is equal to 3 divided by 3 is 1. So x to the third, 4 divided by 2 is 2. So minus 2x squared minus x plus c. And now we use the initial condition, or this just, you know, extra piece of information given to us about the original function. That says when you plug in an x value of 0, you get a y value of 1. And I just thought, since this is a two-part equation or two-part problem, I'd be nice and give us an x value of 0, so it's not too hard to figure out what c is. Okay, so the entire function's value is going to be equal to 1 when x is equal to 0. So 0 cubed minus 2 times 0 squared minus 0 plus c. This is 1 equals c, and oh, okay, so I had, you know, given you an x value of 0, we don't have any work to do, everything just cancels out. And we have c equals 1, so f of x, our original function, is the original function, is x cubed minus 2x squared minus x plus 1, and that means I am done. I'm Mr. Tarrou. Go do your homework.